Good morning from a very sunny London, where the FTSE 100 is currently down from Friday's close. The biggest loser so far this morning is gambling group Flutter Entertainment, which announced last week that it was shutting down its Fox Bet operation over in the US. Here in the UK, though, it's high street lender Halifax that's reporting that UK house prices fell by 2.4% in the year to July. The decline was less drastic than last month's, but it was the fourth monthly fall on the bounce and leaves the average house price here in the UK at around £285,000. Back on the stock market now, and it's another busy week of earning updates here in the city. Card Factory is already out of the blocks this morning, announcing that it believes that its full-year figures will likely be materially ahead of expectations, thanks to strong first-half trading. Shipping services firm Clarksons has failed to please investors, meanwhile, with its interims, as reports of growing revenue and profit were overshadowed by a warning of softening freight rates in the sector. Lloyds Bank has some questions to answer as well after reports emerged of a class action lawsuit that alleges the bank paid commission to car dealers to hike interest rates on financing deals. And finally, in small caps, Rheinbold Resources shares rose as the company said that it's gained the support of the Italian government for its acquisition of the onshore Colle Santo gas field. And that is all for this morning. I'll see you again tomorrow.